During closing arguments, if I do not call your treating doctor to come and testify about the injuries that you have now, can the defense use that against us during those closing arguments? You want to know the answer? Come join me on this walk as I share with you this terrific information. Hi, I'm Gerry Oginski. I'm a New York medical malpractice and personal injury attorney. All right, you might notice I'm shooting video in a different location today. It's actually a deserted island here in St. Martin on the French side. My wife actually comes here to pick seashells, which is a favorite pastime of hers. And it's amazing, beautiful view as you can see in the background. But now I have a few minutes to share with you this terrific information, since she likes picking seashells more than I do. All right, so now the question is, you've been treating with the doctor for many years now. And now, for whatever reason, maybe the doctor's not available or the doctor doesn't want to come in and testify. Now we end the trial without having called your treating doctor to explain to the jury exactly what problems you're having now. During closing arguments, which, by the way, the defense will go first, can the defense now argue that because we didn't bring in your treating doctor to talk about your current injuries, that you really don't have any significant injuries? The answer is, yes, he can. The defense can raise those arguments. The defense can tell the jury and ask them, hey, listen, if really this patient had all these significant injuries, as Oginski and his client claims, where is the doctor to come in and talk to you and explain to you about all of the problems that she's having today? Why didn't they bring in Dr. Jones, who's been treating this patient for the past 4 years? If this was so significant, don't you think they would have made every effort possible to go ahead and bring in this doctor to help you understand why this patient's injuries are so debilitating, why they're so disabling, why they're so significant? The defense can certainly raise that argument, and any good attorney worth their salt is going to raise that argument. Why? Because now he wants to intimate, he wants to show to the jury, or at least hint, that there's a significant reason why we did not call your treating doctor to come in and testify. Now, we might have had a very good reason, a very good logical explanation about why your treating doctor was not able to come in and testify. Maybe he was on vacation, maybe he was physically incapacitated, maybe he was seeing patients or in surgery, whatever the case is. If we don't have a good explanation for why the doctor is not in court and testifying, now we run into the problem of trying to convince the jury that we don't have a problem. Your treating doctor has submitted all of his records into court. Other doctors who have testified on your behalf at trial have talked about and relied on the records that your treating doctor provided to the court. So yes, we have that information, but now the defense is certainly able to raise that argument and to question, why didn't Oginski bring in the patient's treating doctor? Is he hiding something? Does the doctor have something he doesn't want to tell us? Is the injury really not as bad as they claim it to be? And now that's going to raise red flags with the jury to suggest in the back of their mind, hey, maybe there really is a problem with this patient's injuries. Maybe they really are not as bad as we claim. And that can be a significant problem because now we have to address it. And now we have to provide a reasonable explanation to the jury to let them know, listen, we're not trying to hide anything. We would have loved to bring in Dr. Jones to testify, but the reality is he was busy, he was away, or whatever other reason he gives us as to why he cannot come into court. And now, they may say, he could have subpoenaed him. Yes, if the doctor refuses to come in, we can subpoena him. And again, that raises a whole other series of problems, but can the defense turn around and hold it against us if we don't bring in your treating doctor to talk about your current medical condition? The answer is yes, they can do it, and they certainly will. So why do I share this with you? I share this with you because nobody else talks about this. And if you're contemplating bringing a lawsuit because you believe a doctor was careless, causing you significant harm and injury, and now you're trying to decide what to do next, my suggestion is, if you still have questions that need answers and your matter happened in New York, pick up the phone and call me. You know, I answer questions like yours every single day, and I'd love to talk to you. You can reach me at 516-487-8207 or by email at Gerry, G-E-R-R-Y, at Oginski-Law.com. I'm going to go try and find my wife picking shells now. I think she's on the other side of this deserted island. So I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.